Gracias.
Marco, you well?
Yeah, pretty good. Much. Thank you.
Can you start off with the injury situation, please?
Just a problem with Ghana. I finished last game with a small problem, nothing special. We need to assess him again this afternoon and tomorrow and take one decision.
Everyone else is okay?
Yes.
Yeah. You've had a few days to think about the performance against Watford the other night. What are your overall thoughts on how that turned out?
What we did, we do always. We analyse the match as a technical staff, and after we passed for our players the positives and the things we must improve. And it's a routine for us. It's something you do always. And then about last game, we didn't do nothing different. Of course, we had two games closer, Newcastle and Watford, and we did analyze the match to prepare well the next. About my thoughts, I already told you in the end of the match. I think the first 25 minutes, the second half, was one of our worst performance in that moment. I think, like we finished the result for us in the half-time, like we started the match as well. Winning the match, we should do different in the second half, playing home. We have to try to score the second goal. Instead, we are waiting for something happen during the game. Of course, we lost the focus in that 3-4 minutes, we conceded the two goals. Of course, some unlucky as well. When you draw one game home and we score one own goal and we miss one penalty, looks that night we didn't have the luck. But it's part of the game. We have to try to find the ways to score more and to don't concede goals like we conceded that two goals. Because in a normal way we didn't concede that two goals.
Is penalties something that you've been looking at specifically this week? Have you been getting the players to practice them at all?
No, it's something we practice every week, not just this week, not just because we lost we missed the penalty. You are working more or not. It's something you do often, and I can tell you we do every week, and we prepare the games, and you prepare the penalty, the possible penalties you can have or not during the match.
So in terms of the performances, do you feel as if you are still trying to impose your style on the squad?
Of course, it's a process. Of course, it's something you are doing since the first day. You are we have to change something. Of course, we have to analyze what we are doing. In some moments, you are more happy with our performance and we got good results, and the other moments we have to improve. You don't play alone as well. The opponents, they start to understand like you're playing, and you have to create more situations as well. But one of the big difference I felt the last two games home, we conceded goals in some moments, and before we didn't concede it. We were more solid before. Because you know, like the clubs come here at Goodies and now playing against us more solid, like Newcastle played against us, and in some moments the game at Watford as well, but Watford was a different game because they came here to play in a different way as well. But the biggest difference, because we scored again against Watford, we scored twice against Newcastle, we scored once as well, and the biggest difference, because we conceded goals in moments we should do better, clear to me.
So in terms of the strength of your squad, and particularly bearing defensive things in mind, are you happy with the way things are with the January transfer window opening soon? Might you be tempted to go in again and have another look?
Okay, you are always aware about everything. It's part of our job. Of course, my job is to work with the players we have, to develop our squad, to give them conditions to grow as a players and our squad to keep growing as well. Of course, what we can do or not during the next market, let's see, is something you are aware. Everything what we can do always to improve the squad we'll do, but our focus is just in the next game, and after we have time to talk about that situation.
You've spoken about trying to maybe get Andre Gomes to stay here on a permanent basis in the future, but there are reports this morning that other clubs might be interested in trying to sign him in January. Does that affect your situation with him at all?
Nothing, zero. Why will affect us? I know. I don't know what we're talking about. I understand maybe some clubs are linked with him or not. I don't know really, but nothing changed in our way. What's in our mind as well. When you have good players, in your squad, that means the other clubs are looking to them as well. It's, for me, it's normal situation in football. And the right moment, we have time to talk about the situation, and let's see what we can do to keep him or not.
So looking forward to Manchester City. I'm sure you will have seen their game against Chelsea last week. What did you make of the performance that Chelsea put in there, and have they given you some ideas as to how to face Manchester City now?
I watched the game and I analysed the game, like is my obligation as a coach. I will play against normal because it's a very good game to see, to watch, and two big teams as well, and more because I will play week after with the City. In a normal way, I will do that. Two big teams. What I can talk about City, because it's the most important to talk about City now. What I saw again, and the first half, they did everything in the same way, and if the result was different in the half time to them, they are winning, or 2 or 3-1 in that moment, was fair, because they deserved the first half a different result. They play in their way. They had clear more chance than the Chelsea in that moment. But football is that, and they didn't score, and Chelsea scored once in a very good offensive transition. Fast attack, like the Chelsea scored the goal, and after the second half was more or less the same. City trying, and Chelsea scored and closed the end of the match. Of course, we'll have our plan to the match as well. We know how City is a good team, very good team, with a very, very good manager as well. We know we are playing possible against the best Premier League team. And it will be tough for us, but it's a good game for us to enjoy. To challenge one team like City will be tough for us, but our players and our team already show we like this type of games as well.
And is this a good time to be going to Manchester City now? Because it looks like they've got quite a lot of players, big name players, who are going to be missing, question marks over a few others. So the strength of their squad is very strong, but with a lot of those players missing, does that make it more advantageous for you?
I don't see. Just because they are different players, nothing changed in their style, in their style of play, their quality as well. It's easy to understand how they want to do the things, but at the end they do the things really well. A lot of individual quality as well in the tack line to create a chance to score as well. If don't play David Silva, play Bernard Silva, what is the big difference? I didn't see big difference as well. I know maybe you are talking about De Bruyne as well, but this season De Bruyne maybe play twice, 3 games, and I didn't see big difference, and in City teams as well. Okay, and we are talking about two fantastic football players, David Silva and De Bruyne. Possible these two players they don't play, but I think even Fernandinho or Aguero, they didn't play the last game, but I think they will be available to play, and for sure will be a strong side we'll play against.
Just finally, it's the first Premier League game obviously since Manchester City played Chelsea, and we saw what happened with Raheem Sterling and the abuse that he suffered there. He's been saying that he feels as if black players are unfairly treated in the media. I don't know whether you have an opinion on that specifically, but do you feel that racism is a problem within football, within the Premier League, that we have to look at?
Okay, I cannot judge you about the media opinion, because I don't know, I don't read what the media is talking or not about the situation. I'm not the right person to judge about the media. What I can tell you, for me, not just the football, I think the life, but the football is, we have to look to us as a sport, as a party, for all the nationalities, for all the cultures as well. And for me, you have to to be all involved in this situation and to respect the our opponents, to respect ourselves, and to look to the football, to enjoy and to like a party, if I can tell you, because it's a fantastic sport. All of us love this sport, and it's important to respect all of the people are not just in the pitch, around the pitch, and the supporters as well.
Thank you, Marco.
Okay, thank you.